Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today I'm going to cover how to test a printhead with a multimeter. We're going to use L1800 printheads. This is the same printhead as 1430, 1390, and a whole bunch of other printers. It's pretty popular. It's easy, just put the printhead inside the printer and test. However, sometimes the printhead is going to burn the main board. So you don't want to waste a main board to test a printhead. There are some quick tests with the multimeter. However, it's not all conclusive that if it tests in the multimeter is okay, then it doesn't mean it's not going to burn your main board. However, if it tests bad in the multimeter, it will burn your main board. I hope it makes sense to you. Okay, before we get our hands on the printhead, I have to do a little bit of a game for you. How many ways you can pick up those three printheads? You can only pick two. Okay, you got three printheads. I can pick up those two. I can pick up this two. And I can pick up those two, right? There are three ways. But the 20 printheads, how many ways you can pick up two of them? And let's do math. The way you do it is easy. Okay, we're not do 20. We're going to do maybe five. One, two, three, four, five. And pick two of those. The way you do it is you put your finger on the first one. So you do 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5. And then you put your finger over, point at 2. You do 2, 3, 2, 4, and 2, 5. Then you move finger, point to 3. You do 3, 4, 3, 5. And you put your finger on the 4, you do 4, 5. Then you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are 10 ways to pick up two numbers regardless of the sequence. So if you do the sequence, if 2, 1 is different from 1, 2, then you just multiply by 2. And that's how many, there are 10 ways to pick up two numbers from 5. You can see why it's relevant just in a second. You can test on the pins directly. However, what I usually do is I connect to a FFC cable and I test on the FFC cable. I put a cable on, and then on the other end of FFC cable, there's a sequence. So the first one is a little FFC. Underneath, we'll call it the cable number 2, and then we'll call it number 3. If you do this a lot, I will suggest you just get a set of a spare cable for this. It will make it life easier for you. So this cable 1, I'll flip over, and here's cable 2. On the bottom is cable 3. And I mark as 1, 2, and 3. If you do it on the main board, the cable 1 is connection number 12, and the number 2 is connection number 11, and number 3 is connection number 10, and those numbers are marked on the main board. So in the multimeter, we set up to the diode and then register mode, and we select beep. So if it's connected, it's going to beep. Okay, your first day on the job, and your boss gave you a 9-pin cable, and say, can you tell me all the 2 pins that are connected? How you going to do it? Okay, you put your red pin on the first one, test the rest. Then you put the red pin on the second pin, and test the rest, and so on and so forth until you go to the last pair. When we put it in the first one, none of them beeps. The first pin doesn't connect to any pin at all.
Then we do the second one.
2 and 5 is connected. 2 and 7. And 2 and 9. And then we keep going. And we test absolutely every single possible connection. To interpret the result, we go to bchtechnology.com and type in pin chart. You're going to see a pin chart for printhead L1800. Here we can download the pin chart. Let's take a look of cable 1. That's what we're working on. In the pin chart, here's the sequence number from left to the right, from first pin, second pin, third pin. First pin is VHS, is 42 volts input. The green ones are the ground wire, and all the ground wire are connected. However, for the cable 2, you're going to see ground 2. Those ground wires are not connected to the green ground. So you are not going to have a beep in the ground 2. Let's focus on the first cable that we're working on. The first thing we want to test is whether this power input is shorted with the ground. This usually happens. If you see a burning mark, that's because a drop of ink over here. Then you're going to see a spark, and that's going to burn your printhead. So if you print that pin number 1, number 2 is connected, you'll get big trouble. Okay. Because the pin number 1 is white, it's not ground. So if we put a probe on here, and none of them will beep, then we put a probe on pin number 2, and when we go down, we're going to hear a beep at 5, at 7, and we're going to hear a beep at pin 9. So from here, you can see you are having two tests. First test is the voltage input, and you can pick any of the pin. If you do it on the printhead, it's easier if you put one probe here and one probe here. If it beeps, that means you get a short. And you put your probe on any of the ground in number cable number 1, and then you put another probe on the ground of cable number 2. Then you should hear a beep. All the green ones to green ones should beep. All the white one to white one or white one to green one should not beep. So this is how you do the old combination tests. Today we're going to do the ground test. In the future, maybe if I have time, I should video like how you put the voltage in it so you can measure the H hot. If you see the error message, sometimes it says H hot. That's what that means. And for other more detailed trapezoid wheel test. So we just finished the cable 1, the 9-pin cable, and we wrote down all the connections there. I'll put a pin chart for the first cable on the left. And then the pin chart of the second cable on the top right. Supposedly, if I put a probe on the second pin on the first cable, I should be able to hear a beep on the pin number 2 on the second cable and pin number 4 and number 7.
Pin number 2 on the cable 1 is to the ground. And then you connect to the second leg on the cable 2, it should beep. The first one should not beep, the second one beeps, because all those green ones, they are the same ground. And their second ground on the cables at ground 2, those are not connected to the green ground.
And you can use the same theory test cable number 3. Basically, the white to green will not beep, the white to white will not beep, only green to green will beep. Now you understand when you see the people do this on the YouTube, basically you're connecting number 1 to number 9. It's white to green, it should not beep. If it beeps, then something's wrong. Okay, let's test a bunch of printheads. So this one, first pin and second pin.
Can see this one is shorted. So this printhead is not good. If you put it in there, you're going to have a fire starter.
So we don't even have to test the rest. We can move on to the next one. And by the word of burn, the next one will not be good either. First pin and the second pin.
You can say it didn't beep, but the multimeter reading is 57 ohms. 57 ohms is not a lot. So if you get 40 volts in there, and you're going to see a spark. So this printhead, although it did not beep, it's going to burn your mainboard in no time. And you can see a fire display. Okay, we got two failed ones on the power test. And now we're going to test one more.
First test, pin number 1, number 2.
Oh, wow, so test is okay.
The first pin is white, VHV. It should not beep for all of the pins. White should not beep. White to green should not beep. You can just hold your probe on the first pin and the slide through, see none of them beeps. Now we move the probe to the second pin. So second pin is ground, so it should be beep on the 5, 7, and 9.
5, 7, 9. So this cable is okay. So on the third pin,
third pin should not connect to any pin. Fourth, fifth, and look at the kick table. Fifth should connect to 7, 9. 7, 9. On the 7, 7 they connect to the 9. On the 8, 8 and 9 is now connected. Okay, then we can move to the second table and look on the picture. The first one is the pin 1 is white, so it should not be on the other one. Second one is green, so it should be on the 4th and 7th. Second, third, fourth, seventh. Okay, I think I got the idea. I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at www.bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.